So this can increase the vitamin content of foods, it can increase the enzyme production of foods. Some of the best sources, we went over a few this morning, like the beer and sauerkraut and kombucha. We didn't talk about miso too much.
Pull a little farther away on the band and keep your arms straight. Go down.
Another really good example, we do a lot of lacto-fermentation of pickles.
Three.
Cucumbers from the garden that we'll pickle. Kimchi, super easy to make with just shredded cabbage, essentially, and a little bit of whey that you can literally strain off of yolk that you buy at the grocery store.
Good.
Again, if you were to do a search on the internet for kimchi video, there's some really good videos of Jessa on YouTube making kimchi. And kimchi is another really good one. And then, of course, yogurt. If you're getting like an organic, whole-fat yogurt, that's another really, really good way to work fermented foods into your diet. But that's also really important when it comes to digestion.
Last one,
and then, of course, saturated fats. I talked about cholesterols, but certain saturated fats actually have antimicrobial properties. One of those is coconut oil. Another one is grass-fed butter. Two really, really good ways to protect your stomach. Two important things to have in your diet to help aid with digestion. Coconut oil is antiviral, especially if you happen to be someone who has candida. And a lot of times if you struggle with inability to lose weight, with sugar cravings, things like that,